Hello, totally not noisy and annoying neighbors. I'll get back to this one later. I'm Winter, and as you can see, if you managed to read the title of this video, because it's not a very easy thing to do, this is Pass the Parcel, our coal and charcoal, I see. This is Pass the Parcel Season 2! Oh my goodness, that's amazing! But some of you may not know what is happening here, so I will proceed immediately to explain. I mean, it's kind of difficult if you don't know what this is. You should be like only subscribe to me and not to Munchmo and Oberg and never have seen the previous season of Pass the Parcel. Oh, I hate not being able to make enough. Yeah, whatever. Let's do it like this. There we go. That's perfect. So yeah, you should also have missed the first season and to not have any idea what's going on, but let me help you out and tell you what this is about. Where's the... I'm pretty sure there should be iron somewhere in here. Oh yes, there is. Also, there's saplings here. Let's finish cooking this. Also, hello, what do you sell? Oh, you're a wheat guy, that's good. I like wheat guys. Oh wait, I got the iron because I wanted to make some tools real quick, so I'm gonna make a sword, make a pick, not with the cactus. You can't make a pick with the cactus, and a bucket. Number 5. Actually, maybe I'll put this here. Yeah, I'll finish. Yeah, whatever. I need to throw this crap. I can't enter through the door! So, what Pass the Parcel is a single player world played with the ultra hardcore mod, which stops normal health regeneration and makes it much harder to recover lost health. The sun is setting, that's bad. With a twist in that it is a cooperative effort, a cooperative game that is being played in this season by 4 players. The rule is that one person plays in this save file for 30 minutes, records everything, puts everything on YouTube. I'm going to sleep now. Are you the same guy? Oh no, you're going to give me apples. Thank you, but I can get them on my own. Plays for 30 minutes, records, uploads, and then, after all of that is said and done, the save file is given to the next person in line. Which means... doesn't mean anything. then the next person in line does exactly the same thing, plays for 30 minutes, a new optimized version is available. I know, this is 1.4.5, because the old hardcore mod is not updated again. I'll come back to this later as well. Everybody plays for 30 minutes. And they keep passing the save file over and over again. You know what I'll make now? I need fences. And the objective in this season is to kill both the Enderdragon and the Wither. Let me make some more sticks. This is a hardcore world, meaning that if you die, you're out. The next person in line will play from the save file that you... Oh, there we go, that was perfect. 14... I'll make a couple more. Next person in line will play from the last save file you started from, in case you die, so they will just keep on playing without you, and if it's your turn again, you will not get to play anymore, you're out of the game. Except that this time, which is different from last time, because we didn't do that last time, you can be resurrected. So if somebody dies, one of the other players can bring you back into the game, and can do so by crafting a diamond block and burning it into a pool of lava. And this will allow you to get back into the game and play again when it's going to be your turn again. That's going to be useful, especially since I kinda expect the Wither to kinda do some damage. Should I make it bigger? Yeah. Let's... There we go. Sir, the players this time. Ooh, there's a cave somewhere around here. The players this time are Berg, who was the person who got the idea for Pass the Parcel in the first place, so the one who made it all possible previous season and this season as well. Manchmo, who played in previous season as well. Me, amazingly enough, I'm part of the thing I'm recording right now. And the new entry, Ajax. In the previous season there were 8 players, but this time there are only 4. And there's a reason for that. The reason is that last time we killed the Enderdragon when most of us only got to play twice. So we reached the objective with very few people having had the chance to do lots of stuff in here. And it was kind of a shame, so we decided that we needed less players so all of us could get to play more. But since it's a shame that Pass the Parcel would only... Wolf, you're not a duck. There's a need for you to follow me. Oh, that's adorable. Aww. Since it's a shame because Pass the Parcel was a success. People really liked it, they liked the idea, and more people wanted to play than before. We found it a bit of a shame. There's a spider. Not only 4 of us got to play. So we're going to do something like teams. If someone else wants to play in Pass the Parcel, you can set it up on your own. After all, you don't need anything, you just need the old hardcore mod. Come here, chickens, you only need the old hardcore mod and 3 other people. And you start playing with the same rules, a random seed, hardcore world, and so on. And we kind of race and we see who gets to kill both the Enderdragon and the Wither first. So it has become an even bigger thing that anybody can participate in, so if you're interested, you can just find friends, maybe ask around the Ultra Hardcore subreddit, I bet you're going to find lots of people willing to do that. Find friends, make sure you all can record, play 30 minutes each on the same map, keep passing save file around, and have fun. That's the most important thing to do. It should be everything, yep. So Manchmo last time found these chickens, and I'm bringing them back here in the fence thingy I just made. It's hilarious, previous season I brought the chicken to our village as well. That's my destiny, I am the chosen one, the chicken queen of destiny. You chickens. About the Ultra Hardcore mod, I've got this feeling. You know, it took a long while for the Ultra Hardcore mod to be updated when the 1.4 update happened. And it's taken a long while now to update for 1.4.6. Gotcha both. Honestly, when a mod starts doing that, to update very slowly and people just keep spamming the thread being like, when is this going to be updated? That's the sign that the mod is probably going to be abandoned very soon by its creator. Of course I'm sad, also I might be wrong, but that's the feeling I'm getting. Simply because that's what happens with every single mod out there. If the person who made it starts not answering his own thread anymore and not updating it after weeks and months of time, you're stuck in a hole. Yeah, that's a bad sign. I'm not too worried, however. I mean, it's a very, very famous and well-known mod. There's a bucket version, there's... should I get the wheat? I don't even know if you want to trade, the last time a sugar farm wasn't put to any use, oh, actually give me the seeds. So, if the mod is going to be abandoned, I trust in the fact that most likely someone else will just make a very similar mod. After all, it's a very simple concept. Just disable health regeneration and change to recipes. And one drop if you want to do that, the guest drop. Since guests in the old hardcore mod do not drop guest tiers, because that would give you regen potions, and that's a bit too overpowered in this kind of mod. So I'm not worried about it. I feel like sooner or later the mod is just going to be completely forgotten by the person who made it, but and at the same time I think someone else will just make just the same kind of mod as a spiritual successor. They're pigs that way. We have, as Munchmo mentioned, a chicken problem here. He didn't want to go caving without having arrows, and that's understandable. I don't like the idea of caving in ultra hardcore without a bow. We have a bow, we're missing the arrows too much either, although I'm pretty sure that once the sun is down, I will just do that. But we have a chicken problem. Actually, you know what I should do? I know what I should do. I found two chickens, and I'm waiting for them to make eggs, and then breed them some more. But what I should do is go back there, because there can't possibly be only two chickens. So as long as it's day, I'm going to run back there, check real quick if there are more chickens, see if I can't get a couple of feathers. Are you already hungry? No, but there's an egg here. Kapow! Aw. Let me place a block here. Also, this needs to be slightly light up. Did I just hear a cave sound? It was very faint, I'm not too sure. There we go, it's slightly safer. I'm going to go look for other chickens and possibly cave entrance. Yeah, I'm going to go caving, whatever. The noisy neighbors, I promised I would talk about them. Promised, what's the word? I just said I would. Should I leave my stuff? Yeah, whatever. I'm on my way. Yeah. I've been avoiding making videos past couple of days because my surroundings weren't exactly allowing me to make videos. I'd like a flint and steel. Give me some blocks. There's something about Thai people, in Thailand in general, I will never understand or get used to. It's something I really, really don't like no matter how long I've been here, and I will never like it no matter how long I will stay here. I'll never get used to it, and it bothers me so much. Here's another chicken. Should I kill you or bring you back? No, it's going to take too much. Oh, there's lava below here. Ooh. Somewhere around here? I thought it was a sort of surface lava pool. Hello? Is anybody finding... Does anybody see? Oh, not what I wanted. I hear it, but oh, come here, chicken. Come here, chicken. I command you to come back. Oh, the wolves. That would have been. Oh, seriously? Gotcha. Jeez. These chickens are way too smart. Yeah, I'm going to look for this lava pool. Hopefully, it may also lead to a cave, although that's unlikely. And since it's nighttime and it's going to be slightly unsafe, let's do this. Also, might as well place a couple torches around real quick. Kapow, kapow, kapow. And kaboom. Perfect. There we go. Let's see if I can't find this friggin' lava. Oh, found it. Alright, that was easy. I don't need saplings. The thing I will never get used to is how they party. Yeah, just a lava pool. When there's a reason to party. For example, when... You know how usually if, say, you have a son or a daughter, and this son of that or daughter of yours goes to the university, it's something to be very proud of. It's one of the biggest aspirations you can think of for your daughter and or son's future. And that is cool. with this being a very religious country, one of the biggest, the best, there's no doubting it, the best thing that could possibly happen to your son and or daughter, if you're a Thai person, would be for this son and or daughter, no, that's only the sons, because the daughters can't do that, to go and start the training to become a monk. That's the best thing you could ever possibly hope for your son. It's going to make you very, very proud. It's like the best possible thing. You wouldn't be able to think of anything else that would make you just as proud. Also, I forgot to block this. Here we go. Kinda didn't work here. What? Careful, Wolfie! There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and then 2 on top. Yeah, that's correct. Let me make sure this is fine. Okay. So if one of your sons decides finally to start his training to become a monk. You're going to make a big party. And this party lasts. It's a kind of goodbye party because your son is going to go to a temple and stay there for months, if not years. And you will not see him for so long. So it's kind of a goodbye party and at the same time a very happy kind of party because it's something awesome that is happening. It lasts for 3 days, and the way Thai people party, 1, 2, 3, is that they blast music as loud as they possibly can for 3 days in a row without stopping, ever. Without ever stopping. The entire day and the entire night, they're going to make this music blast as loud as possible without stopping ever. I need gravel. Is there gravel behind us? I need gravel. And you can understand why I don't like that. This morning I was pushing my face in the pillow, trying to swallow it, being like, I want to sleep. Oh, I found iron. I just want to sleep. Why are you doing this at 5 in the morning? I have no idea how they could possibly survive after something like that. And it doesn't just happen when one of your... This zombie might just be in a cave. I just heard a weird sound. It doesn't just happen when one of your neighbor's sons is going to become a monk. Whenever there's reason to party, they do it like this. 3 days in a row of music non-stop, and it's very, very, very loud. It drives me insane. I don't know how they could do that and enjoy that. I'm okay with partying, but not just... The music is too loud, even if it's in the middle of the day, but especially in the middle of the night, how could you do that? I do not understand. There's so much iron in my way, and I still haven't found gravel, and I still haven't found that zombie either. I'm getting further away, actually. It might have been on the surface, and I might have just wasted my time. No, it sounds pretty close. I wonder. Zombie! This happens especially when the party is a private one. I mean, if there is some kind of holiday that everybody's celebrating, I mean, do you mind fireworks? You know, during New Year's, it happens every single year, the same day, you can't expect it, you try to not, you know already that you will not be able to sleep, go to sleep early that day. There we go! At least it's a holiday, you know about it, but... And it lasts 1 day, but... This is different. I do not understand. I hear the zombies to my right. Oh! No, careful. I do not have any armor. Wait, what am I saying? I have full iron! Hello? You know what would be awesome? To find a skeleton spawner. And still no gravel. I just... Oh, there's more lava here. How deep am I? Nyeh, still not even gold layer. I found gravel. This is a big cave. Can I, like, this is a lot to block off. Okay. I'm going to explore this branch. Safe. Hello. Oh man, just how big is this? Big caves are... that branch off in so many different directions are very dangerous in ultra hardcore. Give me lots of torches. I'm doing this the boring way. Also, the not effective way. Kaparoo! So yeah, the very loud music also prevented me from, you know, recording a video. Because you could hear it way too clearly. But the thing that bothered me the most... and it always bothers me the most, even more than this, is the bass. Oh, hello! I heard you. I kind of saw you as well. Luckily, you did not see me in time. But there's just this... They're so loud! Sometimes if the part is far away from my home, far enough away from my home, I don't even hear the music itself, but I just hear the bass. Tum, 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 whatever the rhythm? Of it is, and my microphone picks it up every single time. At first, sometimes it would be in one of my recordings, and it happened in one of my Walking Dead videos, I don't remember which one. I could hear this bass sound, it was very rhythmic, and I couldn't figure out for the love of me what it was, because I hadn't realized, I hadn't noticed anything while recording, and that's because the music... Can you shoot me from there? I couldn't even hear the music, I just heard that! The microphone just picked that! Terrible, it's not even enjoyable, if you can't hear the music, also my pick is breaking. I'll never be able to get down here. Also, I still didn't lit up my portal. Let's go momentarily back, I need the gravel. Hello. Hello, gravel. Is that it? There was more. There was more. Somewhere. No? Just these. Okay, let me... Still hear the zombies. Give me one piece of flint. One flint. One flint, please. Flint! There we go, finally! Two even. Thank you! I have one feather, so I can put that one to good use and finally have at least four arrows, that's great. Yeah, this thing is right, like right here. Come on! Where are you? Sorry, Torchy. I didn't mean to do that. Why can't they find you? Driving insane, but whatever. I have important stuff to do right now, and I still got a little bit of time, so that could be nice. Hello. You know what? Slightly dingy. That would have been hilarious. Admit it, it would have been hilarious. There we go. It's going to be fun. Let's make this. Put this somewhere, hopefully it won't catch on fire. Will you catch on fire here? You shouldn't. And if you do, you won't be able to burn me. So that's okay. Let's make one single... Well, four arrows real quick. I need another one of those. Also, I need more sticks. This is a very long stick. Perfect. I have enough torches. What I wanted to do... Nah, I'll smelt the iron later. What am I missing? Or the shovel. I want to make the shovel. Hello there. Right. Let's see what awaits us on the other side. Are you curious? I bet you're curious. Yes, we need to get deeper. Taking a while. Going to the nether while recording is not the best idea ever. Let's... this is 1.4.5, so the world tends to load incredibly slow. Whoa! Not safe. Hello? Hello? So, guys, right in front of you, if you get to the nether, there's a drop. So, don't move forward immediately. Holy cow! There, now it's safe. Let me give the world a bit of time to load. I'll stop recording too, be right back in 1 second. And look at that! Well, that's pretty good to know that there's one fortress just in front of us and shouldn't be too difficult to reach. Seems like there's a path there that can be made. Closest glowstone to us? Not entirely sure. Yikes. Oh, there's another one! There's another fortress there! Okay, this is a good enough nether. I don't have enough cobble to secure the portal. So I'll let the... Oh. That could be a problem. Okay. No, okay. This won't be able to reach us. It's hilarious. Like... Oh! Holy cow! Well... Nether is working against us. That's absolutely hilarious. Ah, all right, this is safe. This is mostly safe. So there you have it. We know now how hostile this Nether is going to be, and getting to that stronghold may just be a problem right now because we kind of have an extra obstacle on our way there. Still, that's what we have to deal with. So I guess I'll. Run back now. Now that we have seen what kind of place we're in, that's kind of cool for just being the third episode, so I'll see you guys on the other side. Right now. Hello. We're back in the real world. Hopefully it's daytime also. That's not the best idea ever. There we go. Hello. Alright, it is daytime. Hi! So just remember, this is where the nether portal is. Not as comfortable as having it just outside of our village, but... we'll have to... I mean, that's not too bad. Let's... actually, I'm out of time, so I should just get back. But I want to see if there's another chicken. A single other chicken. That's a very nice tree. Boom. There we go. We will be able to see more clearly without all the trees. Ah, going back to the village now. The next person is lying. The next person in line is going to be IX. Who will probably bake all of these potatoes right here. Back to the village I go. No more chickens I have found, mostly because I kind of got distracted when I heard the lava pool and I took advantage of that. I got back with some iron and there may be an interesting cave. That cave definitely went down to gold layer, but it's kind of hard to navigate because it's full of... Hi, zombie. It's full of paths that go all over the place, and that is kind of not cool at all. In ultra hardcore, it definitely is not. I'm pretty sure I have more seats with me. Yes, I do. Here, chickens, also don't accidentally set the fence on fire. Oh, what? You're not hungry? You should be. Aww, probably because the chunks were not loaded, so the chickens were not growing, and were not growing hungry either. That's a shame. We haven't checked all the villagers' traits. You're the apple guy. How about you? Hey, come back here. You're the wheat guy. I saw both of you. I already saw both of you. Where's everybody else? What's their trade? Oh, and also, guys, I hate this thing right here. When I saw it, this is a drop, like, the kind of can't really see. There we go. I have saved somebody from accidentally taking fall damage. I hope you thank me later properly. Is there somebody in here? Let me check if there's somebody in here. Hello? Nope. Never mind. Back to my house I go, because I'm at the end of my episode. Oh, drowning testificate! Drowning testificate! Wait, I need to save him! It's important! I need to save him! Here! You're safe! You idiot! Thank you so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed yourself! Munchmo has a playlist with all of our episodes, so you should check out his channel. Make sure you keep up with everything that we are going to do. And Cookie Guy! Next is IX, so keep subscribe to him, make sure, and to Berg and to Munch to keep up with all of our episodes, and have a nice day!